Most live streams have multiple audio sources mixed together into a complete mix that the audience hears. This is what the OBS Studio Mixer is for. I'm Dwayne Berg, here to make OBS less scary and more fun, and welcome back to my tutorial course. The entire course is linked in the playlist in the video description, and if your question isn't answered in this video, please check there. Full production setups, like what I use on some of the shows that I work on, use big mixers like the Behringer X32 for routing and managing all of the different audio tracks and devices. Without it, we wouldn't be able to have a mixed and balanced final audio mix for the videos. While you can definitely achieve better results with a physical mixer like the ever-popular GoXLR, and many top streamers do, the built-in digital mixer in OBS is more than enough for most smaller streamers' workflow. To make the most of the OBS mixer, you have to first set up a few different sections of the OBS audio interface. Let's jump into it. First, you have to set up your audio devices within the audio tab of the settings menu. Here you choose your primary microphone, desktop audio, and additional sources for both. Set up all of the applicable sources for your setup, and then continue. Now let's focus on separating your audio sources into different tracks. I record everything using OBS Studio for the simple fact that I can record each audio source on a different track. This allows for better mixing, application of post-processing to your microphone, or even the complete exclusion of a source in editing. The first step to setting this up is to go into the Output tab in the Settings menu and switch the Output mode to Advanced. Then click on the Recording tab. This is where you will select which tracks will get recorded. You can choose to have up to 6 different tracks saved to your recording. For now, we'll focus on a more standard setup using 3 tracks. Check the boxes for the tracks you want to be recorded. Think about what sources you have and which ones you want separate. If you're just recording, like I'm doing for this video, you may only need 2 for your desktop audio and your microphone. If you're setting up for a live stream and you want to record a copy of the broadcast for VODs or for YouTube highlights, you might want to separate your game audio or alerts as well. Go back to the streaming tab and you'll see why. You have to choose a single track to be broadcast to your stream. You can only choose 1, which means one of the tracks needs to contain the aggregate mix of all your sources. Typically, I use track 1 for this. That's why, at a minimum, I suggest you use 3 tracks. Now, that doesn't mean you have to record all 3. You can have OBS record the individual sources without recording track 1, but still broadcasting it. But we're not quite there yet. As it stands right now, if you recorded something, you would still record every source to every track. Now we have to assign which track each source gets recorded to. This is where the Advanced Audio Properties menu comes into play. There are 2 ways to get into the Advanced Audio Properties menu. First is through the mixer window of the OBS UI. Next to the meter for any source, click the gear and select Advanced Audio Properties. You can also click Edit and then select Advanced Audio Properties. This is where you will select which track or tracks each source will be recorded to, using the grid box of checkboxes on the right side of the window. By default, every box is checked. This means that every source is being recorded to every track. If you're just recording, you can assign each source to a separate track. If you're recording and streaming, you want to assign every source to track 1 and then assign the sources you want to record independently to their own tracks, i.e. track 2 just for your microphone, track 3 for your game sound, and track 4 for your music, for example. With this configuration, all of your audio sources will go to your live stream, and each source will go to its own track for you to edit later. Now you still have to balance all of the sources in your mix if you're streaming using the faders. The most important thing is to make sure your sources are not too loud and are clipping, or distorting. The meters can be a little misleading. The green bar being full is not good. This means you have no room to get louder without clipping, and you never want it to be red. That means you've clipped. You should aim to have your loudest source, probably your microphone, to peak around 2/3 to 3/4 of the way up the meter. Then balance all of your other sources accordingly. Then make sure you do a test recording. Whenever you change any audio settings, you should always, always, always do a test recording. If you try to play your recording and you don't hear all of the tracks, don't freak out. Nothing is wrong. Media players can only play one track at a time. Free media players like VLC allow you to switch between tracks while playing the file. Import your video file into your video editing software and it should load the separated audio tracks. If your video editor doesn't load multiple audio tracks, you can use something like DaVinci Resolve instead. Now, there's been a lot of information thrown at you in this lesson, so let's do a quick recap. First, add your audio devices in the audio settings. Second, select the tracks you want to record in output settings. Then, separate the tracks using the checkboxes and the advanced audio properties of the mixer. My final caveat is that this will only work if you're recording in a file format that supports multiple audio tracks. I suggest MKV because it's crash safe and can be remuxed to MP4 for editing in just about any editing software. Well, that's it for this lesson. If this lesson was helpful for you, please do me a favor, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel with notifications on for more OBS tutorials, tips, and tricks. And if you would like to see any of the lessons from this course in action, come over to Twitch, give me a follow, and say hello in chat. I'll see you next time, and as always, stream on.